Let's talk about loops. So I have a while loop here, and with just a few lines of code, I can write this message all the way down the screen. If I go ahead and change the message like this, you know, to make it better, all of them change. So how is this working? Well, we can revisit this code in a moment, but first let's take a step back and think about how we might write this program using only what we know so far without using loops. So to do that, we're really just going to write a bunch of text over and over and over again, right? We're going to say text, message, we'll put it in the first place. And now it's just a matter of repeating this enough times so that eventually we get all the way to the bottom. And that's going to take a lot of work, right? Because the bottom is really far away. And it's even worse if you then point out to me, hey, this wasn't actually 70, it needs to be closer, it needs to be at like 60. And now that affects this one because it also needs to be smaller and all the way on the more copies of text we have. And in fact, this way it's going to take even longer to get to the bottom. So this is really a pain, and thankfully we have loops to help us. From now on, anytime you see repetitive code like this, your first thought should be, could I use a loop? A loop will let us repeat this piece of code over and over and over again, making just little changes each time. So here's how we would rewrite this code with a loop. To get started, we need to type while, the parentheses, and the curly braces. We're going to get this message, but it's just because we're not done yet. Don't worry, it'll go away when we finish. So every time you write a loop, you need to answer three key questions. And here they are. So the first question is, what do I want to repeat? And whatever we want to repeat needs to go in between these curlies. So we want to repeat the text call in this case. So we'll go ahead and put that in here. But it's a little bit silly, right? Because right now we're just going to be repeating the same call of text over and over, which is not really any good, right? We need something to be changing. That brings us to question two, which is what do I want to change each time? So we want to change this Y position, right? We want it to become 60 and then we want it to become 80. So we'll make that into a variable instead called Y because it's the Y position. And we'll go ahead and declare a variable up here. I'll start it at 40. And now, finally, we just need to be changing Y. We can do that down here. We can say Y gets Y plus 20. And it'll be getting bigger every time. In fact, we can use our lesson from incrementing shortcuts here. Again, just go ahead and use the shortcut. So this is fantastic, and we only need to do question three now, which is how long should we be repeating this? Well, we want to do this over and over and over again, but we don't really want to do it forever, right? If we do it forever, first, that's a really long time to wait, and second, it might even crash your browser, but hopefully not. So really, we only want to do this until we get to the bottom of the page, right? Which means we want to do it as long as y is less than 400. So we can just put that in here, and there we have it. We have this message being written all the way down the screen. And you can see that this is way simpler than our previous approach, which, you know, took about as long to write, but we weren't even, you know, a quarter of the way finished. So we can get rid of that, and there we have our program. Now, let's try to get a better understanding of what's going on. To do that, I'm going to print out y each time. I'm going to say y is now. And then down here, I'll just tack y onto the end of the message so we can see it. So at the moment, the value is changing by 20, right? And we can change that just by changing this variable here. We can make it, you know, like 50. And now we have it changing by 50. Similarly, you can go ahead and play with these other values and have them change. And you can see how that affects, you know, where the program stops. So to understand this, you can think of it sort of like an if statement, actually. We have our Boolean expression in here, just like you learned. And then we do the body of the statement, this part, only if the Boolean is true, and otherwise we just jump to the end. But what's interesting is that with a while loop, we actually have this secret thing going on at the bottom, which says, go back to the start of the loop. And what this secret instruction means is that instead of leaving and just keeping on going, like with an if statement, every time we do the loop body, we're going to go back and check if the condition is still true. If it is, we're just going to repeat one more time. And just like you might have guessed, the second time we repeat, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to check, hey, you know, go back to the start. Is y still less than, you know, 279? And if it is, we'll repeat one more time and keep checking. And if it's not, we go back to the start here. Then finally, we'll get to escape, and we'll get to keep going with our program. So great. There are a lot more interesting ways of using loops we're going to learn about soon. But for now, you're off to an excellent start.